Poland is well known for its cuisine, architecture, and agriculture. Yet, due to a series of events which have recently occurred in the nation, it might soon become known for something else, earthquakes. Despite being a nation which experiences a very low number of earthquakes, Poland has been struck by a little more than 2,600 earthquakes since 2000. The largest of these were two magnitude 5.0 earthquakes, creating up to MMI-7 shaking when they struck in 2010 and then 2020. If we turn on the seismic hazard map for Poland, the area which has the highest hazard and thus should be experiencing the highest number of earthquakes can be found bordering the nation of Slovakia to the north around the city of Zakopane. Yet, instead, Poland's earthquakes during the last 24 years have primarily been clustered in two supposedly lower-risk regions. While this might be initially confusing, the cause of most of these earthquakes soon becomes clear once they overlay areas with a high mineral and natural resource potential. As the majority of these seismic events are not simply typical earthquakes, but rather what are referred to as induced earthquakes caused by human activity. In the case of a magnitude 4.2 which struck on January 3, 2024, its epicenter provides a clue as to what exactly triggered this earthquake. Centered 1,600 meters away from the edge of Zelazny Most to the northwest, that feature represents a massive tailings reservoir. I am not implying that this reservoir on its own created this earthquake, but rather that the numerous nearby copper mines and other underground mines did. As, just like fracking, wastewater injection, and geothermal energy production, mining is also our primary cause of induced earthquakes. Even the emplacement and filling of a large water-filled reservoir can sometimes induce earthquakes, such as when a magnitude 6.5 earthquake allegedly linked to the recent filling of a reservoir was triggered in western India during 1967. All of these partially human-caused earthquakes were not purposely created, but were instead the result of human activity changing the level of stress underlying faults had previously experienced. In the case of a small river, which was impounded by a dam and turned into a deep lake, the increased mass of overlying water can place additional strain on an underlying fault, making a fault line more likely to rupture. However, the opposite is also true if you remove large volumes of rock which previously helped hold a fault line in place. In that case, the reduced amount of overlying rock which can be caused by mining makes it easier for a fault line to move, creating an induced earthquake. These types of induced earthquakes due to mining can even be quite dangerous and deadly despite generally involving only a small magnitude event. For example, in 2016, a magnitude 4.4 induced earthquake resulted in the deaths of 8 miners, while in 2022, a smaller magnitude 2.7 resulted in the deaths of 10 miners. Induced earthquakes are especially dangerous at underground mines as not only can they trigger collapses, but they can cause points of weak rock to literally explode and fragment into thousands of tiny particles, almost like a grenade. This phenomenon is known as a rock burst, and it is part of the job of certain geotechnical engineers to prevent or reduce these events from occurring. Thus, while the majority of Oklahoma's earthquakes originate due to wastewater injection related to oil and gas extraction, in Poland, the majority of earthquakes originate due to primarily copper and coal mining. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.